I think I'm live now. Let's see. Is everything good? Yes, there it is. Hey, everybody. Thanks for joining the IBM Developer Twitch stream that we're doing today. Today, I'll be working with Tabnine, and I have a good friend of mine now. Let's see if I can figure out how to do this. Hey, Yot, are you there?
Hey, I'm here. How's it going?
Good, good. How are you, sir?
I'm so great. Thanks for having me, JJ.
Yes, wonderful. So before we go any farther, how about you introduce yourself? Tell me who you are, what you've been doing, and why you're here.
Okay. Hello, everyone. To anyone who is watching this right now, I am Yotam, also known as Yot for some people. Yotam Shinan. I'm a developer advocate at Tabnine. And the reason I'm here today is to talk about AI for code and how it's going to change everyone's lives.
All right.
Mostly. We can talk about that and rock and roll of the 60s. Two things that I'm familiar with.
Wait, did you say ants? Like the little guys that like walk around? Like little ants?
No, I didn't say. I didn't say ants. Maybe what I said and. Maybe I said and.
And oh, but, I'm sorry.
But I like ants too. They're cool.
Nice. Nice. Awesome. Yeah. Awesome. Yes, and hello everybody. I'm JJ. I'm a developer advocate for IBM Cloud. I'm actually very excited about this because the idea of using ML, right? Make sure I get this right, Yot. Using ML to help me write code is a pretty interesting conversation right now. So we're gonna have some fun with this and
we're gonna go
from there. So let's just start kind of from the ground up. Why would I come to Tabnine to use your software?
Well, because this is 2021 and the days that you were coding on your own and trying to figure out everything by yourself and trying not to break your mechanical keyboard because you're frustrated, those days are over. And we have machine learning and AI models that are smart enough to understand what you're trying to do and to help you get the work done quickly, more accurately, and hopefully with some more fun to it. So Tabnine is one tool, is the one tool that you should add to your workflow while you write your code. And nice. That's one reason to use it. Another reason is because I ask you to.
Oh, seems like a reasonable thing to say. Yeah. So we've got a couple conversation popping up in our chat. I just kind of want to throw a couple of these up here. First of all, so Ninja, yeah, probably a good question. What is IBM? It's International Business Machines. It is a corporation that does a lot of interesting computer work, and it's been around for a few hundred years. That's a good way to describe it.
Yes, since the Roman Empire, yeah, more or less.
Pretty much. And you might have a friend here. So sniping 6969 on Discord, Rahul, so you might want to say hi to him.
Yeah, great to see all the friends here. I think we're going to see a bunch of them. Thank you all for showing up.
Yeah. Oh, this Lost Algorithm has already spoken my language. Local models and a Vim plugin has me sold. Yes, Lost Algorithm, you are absolutely right. That might be one reason why we're having this conversation. So that's really cool stuff. So yeah, great. This is awesome. Okay, so you've told us why. So we're gonna try to get this to work with VS Code here in a minute, and play with one of our demo applications we have at IBM to show off some microservices. But let me ask you a question about modern day development, where Tabnine can fit in this. So we use, like, moving into cloud native, You build a lot of microservices, right? You build a lot of functions that just do things, right? Mm-hmm. So if I'm trying to write a function from the very beginning of doing something, how is Tabnine going to know what I'm trying to do? like it's a chicken and egg problem. No, like if I'm writing a function to do that, like is it going to try to see what else I've done and be like, oh, you really need an API to do this? Or how does that kind of portion work?
I'll try to answer this question without diving too deep into technical specs. Tabnine is not thin air. Just a little bit of background. Tabnine is an AI model that was trained using the GPT-2 technology. That's a natural language processing model. Okay. That was trained on natural language, on English. So you can ask it to write a paragraph given when you give it three or four keywords, and it will understand what you're trying, where you're going with this, and it will generate a paragraph that is probably what you were aiming for. So we took the GPT-2 abilities, and we let it, and we trained 2 million pages of licensed repositories from GitHub, and we made it understand code of all languages. So when you're writing your function and you're writing it from scratch, you're probably not inventing a new programming language. You're using a programming language that already exists, and you're taking bits and parts of the language APIs to build your own function. So Tabnine will, line by line of code, will understand where you're going with this. It might not understand immediately what you're trying to do, but while you write a function, line by line, it will get smarter and smarter. Nice. I will dive deeper into that later, but I hope this answers your question.
It really does, and that's actually really clever, and I like it. And I like that throwing the license bit there. That was clever. I'll give you points for that one.
Thanks.
So, so we have a couple more questions just popped up in the chat. Ninja Morph, the best thing to ask is however we can help. What are you looking to learn? That's what we're here to do. Like, we're both developer advocates. Our job is to be resources for you to use what we know about and try to be so you can be successful. And it looks like Lando M says they love Tabnine. The challenge is the configuration. Do you have anything to talk about with that for Lando right there?
I think I'm missing some information here because I think they're talking about specific configuration for a specific IDE.
Okay.
I need a little more info about what's the problem with the configuration. I'm not the support team of Tabnine, but I'll try to help whatever I can.
You get everything thrown at you when you do a live stream. You really
yeah,
do.
Yeah, it's all right. I also have great pancake recipes.
Nice, I like it. Actually, we're gonna talk about those in a minute. So Lost Algorithm says, as someone who switches languages, is fine tuning the GPT models done on a per project basis? Oh, that's a good question. So
yeah, someone often switches languages. Is that fine tuning? If I understand the question correctly, I need to write it again, to read it again. I'm sorry. As someone who often switches languages, is that fine?
The fine tuning.
The fine tuning of the GPT-2 models done on a per project basis. I think this question can be answered with something that we call private model. Meaning that we have an option to let teams that work together on joined accounts of Tabnine we can let our model learn locally without us learning that too, because we're not using anyone's code. I promise that. We can let the model understand specific patterns and methods that are used in a specific project in a specific language. That can be done privately to for a specific usage. Nice. Yeah, we can do that. We can do that.
Nice. Awesome. And Lost Agron says, thank you. So we got one more, then we're going to actually start doing some fingers on keyboards, because I know it's great to having questions and all, but you know, the whole point is to show this thing off, right? So Battle Dash says, Tabnine is amazing with JavaScript, reaching trying with the Java version. and can use some work, and I don't understand the context well, but it sounds like there's huge potential to pull more Java, because if you didn't know, JavaScript and Java are two totally, totally different languages. So
the questions about Java are being raised all the time. On a side note, Tab 9 emerged from an older version of our company that used to be called Codota. Mm-hmm. And Codota was also an AI powered code completion tool that was focused on specific languages with Java among them. Mm-hmm. And in this past few months, we've been transferring all the work that Codota used to do from Codota to Tab 9. Some adjustments are still being done while we speak, by the way. Mm-hmm. And the Java completion model will be perfected within 2 weeks or months, but it's already working. And the more you use it, if you're writing Java, the more you will use Tab 9, you will see how it gets better by the day.
Awesome. Rock on, man. By the way, I'm just gonna just my own 2 cents here. Is it called Tab 9 because a tab is 8 spaces and it's just that one more space that you need?
I don't want to lie, so I'm not going to make up an answer. I just don't know.
Okay. All right. That's fine.
Sorry,
that's fine.
I don't know.
That's fine. Put you on the spot there. What can I say? As my face just turns bright red by the embarrassment of not thinking that you might actually know that. Anyway, that's why we do this live, right? It's fun
Mine
stuff.
Too.
Fun stuff. Yeah, it's fun stuff. Okay. So NinjaMore, thank you so much for putting out that statement. Yes, we'd love to help however we can. And it looks like, we got a Mostyn Cox. There's a tab. I lost my screen. Somebody wants a Tab 9 t-shirt, it seems.
Yeah, that's a Tab 9 t-shirt. We'll let you see it.
Yeah, it's
what
good
a wonderful
stuff,
code.
Yep, some good stuff. Good stuff.
Yeah, we have a whole collection of merch.
Yes. We got a Christian. He'll say it. He'd take one too. But back to NinjaMorph. Yes, if you're just stepping into this world of computer science and you're really interested in AI, that's awesome. Tab 9 is a way to leverage AI and ML, actually technically ML, because AI and ML are different, right? Am I right on that? Yes. Yep. Okay. Good enough.
They're in the same category, but yeah, good enough. We won't dive into that.
Yeah.
Well, not today.
Let's go grab some PhD students real quick. Hang on. but no, in all seriousness, Tab 9 is a tool that leverages ML to make your writing of code better or easier, I should say, or help with the flow, if you will. And we're about to, as soon as I hit a button after answering this question, we're actually going to be installing it on my local machine, playing around with a Node.js application that we do for our demos at IBM. And then hopefully we'll see how it all plays together. I'm really excited about the Docker portion of this too, because I'm a sysadmin at heart. And if it can make my Docker files better, I am sold, and this is all money to me. So okay, let's go.
Let's go.
All right, here we go. And if everyone's curious or wants to know, this is the first of all, here is the Tab 9 site, and I also can put this up as a banner, or I could if I could find it, but I can't. So I'll just throw this in the chat real quick. Comments right there. And go to the site, check it out. Now, you wanted to mention something else about students. It turns out we have a couple students in the chat. So how about you just take a quick aside and talk about /students.
That's right. So any students out there or in here right now, we invite you all to take advantage of our generosity. No, just mm-hmm. kidding. It's not our generosity. We just want to make sure that the dev community is being treated correctly. So we are not charging anything from students who want to use our pro version of Tab 9. You just need to sign up. It's very quick. It's very easy. And have fun. Take it while you can. Just grab it. Grab it and run.
I love it. So it turns out y'all have a Discord too, it seems. So do you want to plug that real quick as a place to find some help?
Yeah, sure. I will post the invite link here in a moment.
Perfect. Yeah, just throw it into the chat. It's the chat's ephemeral. It won't be here forever, or won't be so people can't steal it later. Okay. All right. So I think we've given a pretty good general idea of Tab 9 here. And I will zoom in also on this one so you can see it. This is the actual app we're going to be playing with today. Tab 9 nodes. B travels. Yep. I am attempting to zoom things in. Most of the stuff we'll see are going to be on my terminal and on VS Code here in a second. I just wanted to make sure people had access to seeing all this stuff. What we're going to be going with. Let's see here. Mostyn Cox had a question about the student email problem. If they don't have a student email, can they use the GitHub or something like that? Is there another way to get around this?
We have solutions for that too. We know that not anyone who's trying to make their first steps into the dev world are necessarily studying in an institute that has their own email account. Mm-hmm. And we have ways to allow and to grant access to our pro version, even if you don't have some university email account. We can do that also.
Perfect. All right. So we've talked about this quite a bit. You know, it sounds like there's some really interesting opportunities here. So let's actually get this thing going here.
Okay. So you can just go to the page where you're in right now. That's tab9.com/install. There's just a list of the IDEs that Tab9 supports. If you click on any of them, you'll just get instructions. But since we are we'll be using VS Code today, you can just turn on your VS Code and go to the plugin station, or you can just press install from here, and it will take you straight there.
Perfect. It's
very easy. You just press install. You wait for a minute for the model to be fully downloaded to your machine. Okay. And that's the time also to mention that Tab9 works locally by default. And that's important because we care about privacy, and we want to make sure that if you're working on a project that has vulnerability or you work under any restrictions of the organization that you're part of, and you don't want anything to leak out, then that's totally possible. The whole piece of GPT-2 model, that's pretty crazy. It's going mm-hmm. to be in your machine. You can work offline. It will still work. We also have a cloud option that sends bits of code as a query to our cloud services, just to process the code completion, the suggestions that Tab9 can generate for you. The whole process is encrypted. Nothing stays on our servers and then goes back. The benefit of that is, of course, that it will take off some of the computing resources of your machine. But then again, it works just perfectly in anyhow.
Awesome. So a good friend of ours, Lost Algorithm, asks, does this need a GPU? Can this all be done with just a CPU?
This can be done with a CPU, no problem. Okay. Yeah.
Perfect. All right, so looks like we got that. And now we can come over to VS Code. And it looks like we are installed.
You can see it. If you see it, actually the font is pretty small, so
yes,
it's a little hard
right
for
there.
Me to see. But right then, you see it down there, the status bar. Yeah, this means that you're ready to go. You can, if when you click on it, that just took you to the hub, to the Tabnine hub inside your IDE. You can make some adjustments here. Once you have a pro account, you can choose how many suggestions for completion it will show at any time, if to use just the local model or to send the queries to the cloud. You can join our Discord server from here, as you can see, in our Slack community. Mm-hmm. You can get straight to our support system. Interesting stuff.
So we had a follow-up question on the GPU. If I have a GPU available, can this work also with a GPU?
Yeah.
Cool. That means absolutely nothing to me. I don't understand that, but let's just go ahead and say.
That's under the hood things.
Under the hood. Got it.
Yeah.
Okay, so as you said, everyone gets the free tier from the ground up, and we're not going to worry about let's show it off working for just the free tier. And then if we have some extra time, we'll go into the paid side here.
No problem.
So we got a configuration path and I'm assuming that's the actual models directory is right there. And then the local model, I'm assuming that's a hash of what's going on here. I'm sorry. Is this way too small? I need to make this bigger.
Yeah. It's a little too small.
Okay. Is that better?
Now wait a second. Yeah, that's the actually. That's one part of the hub that I think I will need to consult the rest of the dev team to
completely understand. No worries. I would imagine there would be like a hashing algorithm around the model, so you know what version you're running or whatever. Okay, so we have the hub, we have Tabnine installed, and if you weren't seeing it earlier, that's what Yolt was mentioning. There's a nice little Tabnine
hub.
Hub is this right here. So we'll go ahead and close that. And then we have B Travels. I've already checked it out. So if I go and over here and I just went brain dead. If I go ahead and open, where the hell did open go?
You can just, like this one. Yeah. Just like that.
My brain is just not working for some reason. So we'll go over here. And again, that's why we do this stuff live, to show how ridiculously hard even using JJ's laptop can be. And then we go down to B Travels and B Travels node, and we'll open this up. I trust these authors.
You should trust them.
I really should. I know them all. let's go ahead and open that workspace to make life a little easier. And then Tabnine is starting here.
And Tabnine is already working.
It's already working.
It's already locally scanning your project and starting to understand what the bits and parts of every code line is supposed to do.
So back to the natural language process. I'm not going to try to say that name. If you suggest source comments, that would be fire. I'm assuming there's a good way for it to figure out what the function does and maybe write some comments around what's going on. Is that possible?
I think that's this question is referring maybe a little bit to another AI for code tool.
Let's walk past that one. Don't worry about that. It's fine. It's fine.
But Tabnine can complete regular words that are written in comments, and yes, it can also understand the context of what you're trying to do. For instance, we can let's do it now.
Okay.
Choose any JS file that you have there.
All right. Well, that would be under services. Let's go ahead and just say UI backend.
Yeah, someone answered this pretty nicely. The tab 9 autocompletes. That's a Laundmo. Laundmo. Tab 9 autocompletes everything, but it does not generate comments. You have to start writing comments by yourself, but it will autocomplete them. That's correct. It can autocomplete comments, not necessarily the way you want it, because what you're writing in comments is everything that comes up from your head. But if you're writing a comment, let's say a to-do task that you're writing for yourself. Okay. For example, fill up an array of user IDs, or you know what? Let's go wild here. Fill up an array, not user IDs. Fill up an array of colors, of color names. And now, if you go and now, you already see suggestions here. By the way, the suggestions that you see in the drop-down menu, that's tab 9. Now, if you go down one line and you create a variable called colors, it can be var, it can be let, can be const, and open an array. Just put the start a string with start with one color, let's say red. Now try another one.
Oh wow.
You see what's going on?
That's slick.
So that's one thing. Yeah. That's the most basic example of things that can be done. That's tab 9 understanding the world, not just code. It knows that there is a world, it has colors, and some of them are red, green, yellow, and blue. By the way, you can go on with this. You want to see another example?
Yeah, no, that was just cool. That was just straight cool inside itself, man.
Yeah. Let's do something else. Let's create a constant that's called months, like months of the year.
Oh, rock on. Rock on. Okay.
Yeah.
That is pretty damn cool. That is cool. It's so cool. And I like how it gave you the majority of them, right? Like, or the first one. So like, that is really cool. Sorry. So
these are things that are coming like out of the box. This is actually GPT-2 and understand knowing things from before. But as you work and as you write your code, the local model is starting to understand what you're doing.
Yeah.
And it will suggest completions that are based on the file that you're currently working on, with context of the tasks that you're trying to solve, that you're trying to get done. Mm-hmm. And we can see it in action. Unless you wanna talk about something else.
Oh, this is great.
You wanna see more examples?
Yeah, like anything here. Show me anything, man. That alone is just really, really cool.
Okay, so let's take the file that you're currently in. Okay.
Yep.
I need to see a little bit more of it just so I can understand what we can add to it.
This is unfortunately because of screen like zooming in, we could probably find a better file too. I just grabbed a random JS file. So let's take a quick aside real fast and bring back up the travels, and they moved this around since I've looked at it last. So I was hoping to get this main page so we could like throw something up here and change something around. And it looks like the back end here, it listens on port 9000 and it is running Express. So I think this might actually be it. Let's see here. These are all the back end APIs. So no, this is not the actual front. This is the back end API. Hence the term back end, JJ, wake up. Need more of my caffeine. Here we go. Public.
There you go. You probably need the source file, not the public. The public is just the assets.
Good call. Usually. Good call. Good call. So here we go. Here we go. Here's the actual render and all that. Just so everyone else can catch tag along, we are looking at this right here, which isn't much because it looks like it brings in other stuff.
Maybe we should choose a file that has more processes going in and not just an index file.
Yeah, exactly. Maybe this router right here looks better, right? No, still not a lot. Theme. No, that's just a theme. If I had done my homework, I would have done better. I'm sorry. Sorry, yo. I'm failing you here.
It's all right. You can use install Tabnine. I'm reading some of the comments. Someone is suggesting, well, I should probably mention who. Retool Kamesh. Suggestion, instead of going install Tabnine for IntelliJ, or install Tabnine for WebStorm, or install Tabnine for PyCharm, you can use install Tabnine for JetBrains IDEs, as all of the JetBrains IDEs follow the same plugin install method. I wish that was true. That could have made things so much easier, but unfortunately, each one of them has their own specifics about how the plugin should behave and where it should sit and how much it should weight and what should be the color of the font and so forth. Mm-hmm. We wish we could combine them all together, but we have to give each one its own special treatment. But thank you.
I'm going to bring my sysadmin back out here. And let's say we're going to add a new service to our Docker compose file. I have a feeling that might be an interesting okay. add here. So
if you feel, let's go where you're feeling comfortable. So right now as we speak, Tabnine scans this file and is waiting to see what you want to add in or change. Everything that you will write will get completions that are based on the code that is already written in this file specifically. Plus, it makes sure that it's specific. This is a Docker file, so that's a YAML file. And Tabnine understands YAML because it was trained on all sorts of pages in GitHub from all sorts of repositories, and some of them were also YAML. So it will provide suggestions with the correct syntax to make sure that you don't have syntax errors. So you're getting two benefits here. First of all, you don't need to write as much because suggestions are showing up. And you can rest assured that the syntax is correct and you won't get any errors that you won't be able to find later.
Seriously, just putting that out, like just putting these eight lines of code with the tab completion there for it to do what I needed to get done. Like I genuinely am in love. This is bonkers. Like the amount of effort that I was like, hey, okay, I'm building a database. It was like, oh, cool, you're doing a database. Here's the build that you need to get done. That's fine. I realize I'm walking through this again, but I was able to think about the things I needed. I just tabbed out what I needed, and I added a brand new service on my Docker compose file, eight lines of code with even a depends on, where I always put that as one word, right? And it was like, no, there's an underscore there. You're good to go.
That's the kind of feedback that we get a lot. People saying that they're not writing their code anymore. They're just tabbing down and making sure that everything is correct. And I think also that it's better to have one line of code while you write it, instead of, let's say, getting a whole code block. And then you have to go through it and make sure that it's exactly what you wanted and the way you wanted it, which gradually will take more time than just tabbing down line by line and seeing your code being processed from your hands and under your supervision, with no with with minimal to no mistakes. Thank you for showing up, Ninja Morph.
So awesome. All right, so let's take it to the next step here. I use Docker all the time. This is not a great example now that I'm just looking at it. But if I wanted to add, I want to run, apk. Oh, no, this isn't actually in the file, though. That's a bad example. Okay, hang on. I'm playing now, Yot. Give me a minute. Give me a minute.
No worries. We're all having fun here. And Ritul Kamesh is explaining himself. What I was trying to say is installing the plugin, which you're explaining, when I click the IDE logo on the website, I just command plugins, marketplace, tab 9, click install. It follows the same method to install a plugin in any JetBrains IDE I have used. I understand. Maybe I don't understand. Do the Docker course, please. Oh, he is also asking you to do a Docker course.
Yeah. So I just dropped a note there for Rathul. Please just drop me a note. That is really my email address at IBM. I'll absolutely help you out with that. Hell, I can walk you through. So I can make you a power Docker user real fast. Don't worry about that. That's my world. So Lando or Landmoon asked, is there any reason not the pro version? So we're asking, hey, free's cool, man. But let me see the real money. So you want me to go turn that on real quick?
Go ahead. I think your email is already registered. I made sure you have it. So from the Tab 9 Hub, you can just sign up, mm-hmm. or sign sure. in. Actually, sign mm-hmm. sign in. Actually, yep. Yeah.
And this is where that private, comes in too, right? The private model is also available here. I'm gonna make this normal size again so I can actually see the changes. Give me one second. What's going on here? And
there you are. You're logged in.
Yep.
Let's just scroll down a little bit in the hub to see that scroll up. It's the font is so big.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
yeah.
The irony is that it's way too big. I'm trying to bring
now. Now you're in Pro. Okay, so the main difference. Actually, there are a few differences. First of all, now that you're a Pro user, you can tell Tab 9 how many suggestions you want to see with every time it suggests completion to the code line. Excuse me. And now you have a much stronger model working. So completions can be suddenly a lot longer and faster and more accurate. But having that said, the free tier of Tab 9 works just fine, and it understands your code and it learns your code with time. It's not a dead option. It's great. It might be, but the only problem is that it will, there's a daily limitation of how much you can use it.
Ah, okay.
We are a business after all. We need to bring bread to our tables.
Of course. So I'm just answering one of the questions from Lando. Yes, I'm sorry that I keep zooming in and zooming out. One of the challenges is the software we're using right now doesn't allow me to mess with that kind of stuff very easily. Hopefully, the next stream that you see me on, I'm moving over to a different piece of software where I'll actually have something a little bit better. But, you know, one of the disadvantages of, you know, computers and monitor size and internet problems. So normally you just zoom in and call it a day. Okay. Rathul, thank you so much for dropping that email. And I really do look forward to helping you out on that.
Okay. This is the Docker course?
Yes. Looks like I'll be doing the Docker course. Hey, I mean, you're more welcome to join me on that too if you want.
Can I be there?
Yes. How about I teach? See, you teach me Tabnine, which you're doing now. I'll pay it back by teaching you some Docker. That's a perfect example.
That would be the best deal of the year.
All right. I'm dead serious. Let's make this happen. Let's make this happen. We'll do it.
Okay.
We'll
see, yeah. Okay. You all saw this here for the first time.
Wonderful. Okay. So one of the cool things that I think Lando, by the way, I'm just going to call you Lando from now on because it looks close enough to your name. Was that take a long shot? So do we want to try something out here with that long shot to see if it actually gives us a whole
try thing? Try a long shot.
All right. So I was doing a database, and then I need to do an image. And I want to do Postgres. It's weird trying to think about having to do this and having to see if it, you know.
I wish I could give you like examples to use, but I know very little about Docker files and the way that they work specifically. Was that anywhere accurate?
It's actually pretty close. That's actually real close to what I would want. HPGA. It's close enough. This is all fake anyway, but Etsy Postgres. That's pretty damn close, man. Ports of. Yep, that's right. Yeah, that was pretty damn close, man. I'm not gonna say like there's a couple things I wouldn't tab everything out, but that would actually get a Postgres database container up and running on Docker Compose pretty close.
The thing is that when you're working on a project, you're not just working on it for 1 hour. You usually work on a project if it's a running project, you can find yourself keeping working on it for a long time, can be a few days or a few years. Mm-hmm. And the more that you will work on the same project, Tabnine will be more familiar with it locally in your machine. And so with time, right now these are the first suggestions that Tabnine suggests to your account while in pro mode.
Yep.
And if you will keep using it, then you will see that in 3 days from now, if you will be working, let's say, I don't know, 30 minutes a day on this specific project, within a few days, you will see that you get completions that are extremely accurate in the context of your specific code.
Yep. It's good stuff. This is great. Like, I agree that the examples I have been showing, unfortunately, they changed this app around since I looked at it last, so I don't know where anything is. So that's my bad, and I apologize. But at least with showing off just the basic of the filling in of the variables for us, and also it building out that whole block for a Docker Compose file. If you don't live in the Docker world or deal with that stuff, that's just annoying. It really is. And for it to know all that for me right off the bat,
it seems to me that working on these Docker files, I don't know, from the glimpses that I saw here and there, it feels a little bit like repetitive work.
It is.
You keep creating what the same what are they, buckets?
Yep. Same. Well, I call them stanzas, but I think that's like even wrong. But to me, it's a stanza of like a poem. But yeah, as you see, like it's this whole Docker Compose V2 is basically the same thing over and over and over and over again. You have to write this shit out by hand because the stuff changes as soon as you add a new service to it. And that's the nightmare of microservices.
So that's where Tabnine can really become handy to get these files up and running within a few minutes instead of not a few minutes, a lot of minutes.
Exactly. That's so good. All right. So, and this is great. Thank you so much for all these questions and thoughts. I'm looking to see if there's anything else we can jump into. I really, really wish I had someone who knew some software better than me. Lando was mentioning also the Python support. I'm assuming the Python support is pretty solid too. Give me one second here. I might have a Python. I have a Flask app that I've been playing around with. Let me see if I can bring that up real fast. Maybe that'll be something else to look at.
Okay.
I'll save. Come on, JJ, pick up.
I think we can also take suggestions from the comments if anyone wants to see how Tabnine applies to a specific function in Python. I myself, I'm a JavaScript guy, so I'm a little bit less familiar with it, but Tabnine has written an entire including distance function for me in the past. Yeah, these are the sort of things that Tabnine can do. Searching for a specific Python project you have there.
Actually, here's a little fun project that I was doing with my daughter. Do you know what turtle is?
A turtle? You mean the animal?
Yeah. Well, yeah, that's actually true. Do you know what the animal turtle is? Okay. Cool. So it turns out there's a turtle graphics system built inside of Python, and we wrote this little program here. That actually creates a bunch of racers. So as you saw here, here's a bunch of colors that you were mentioning earlier. So if we wanted to add some logic here to, I'm trying to think here. Hold on, let me just start this real quick to make sure it's still running. I know my daughter was playing with it a little while ago. Not gonna call my daughter out on it, but sometimes things go weird. Second here, so if I do source.env and activate, because I'm a good Python developer, I do everything inside of a virtual env.
And a great father also, apparently.
If I do turtle here, turtle graphics, we're going to do 10 races, 10 racers. It brings up 10 little racers here. And who's going to win? Who's going to win? Yep, who's going to win?
I'm betting. No. It's gonna be the purple, or the blue one.
Go orange.
It's gonna shine.
Brown one.
Damn.
Yep. So as you saw that,
lost all my money there. Now I don't know. I'm gonna keep on working.
Weren't we betting a lifetime license for me for Tabnine? Wasn't that what was going on here?
You just won it actually.
There you go. You gotta have fun, right? Gotta have fun.
So you want to try to add some functionality to it?
Yeah.
It can be even something in the UI. Change the.
So let's go ahead and. Let's do a little bit more error checking. You can always do better error checking, right? So we're going to do, so we make sure that the number's a digit, make sure that it's an integer, and then if it's not numeric, try again. And let's just say, let's add another input here of, let's actually try to pick some of the colors. How about that?
Okay.
Color of input of, I should probably be better about this. Again, you're watching me live, so I'm thinking here. Enter the color of the turtle. So cool.
Yeah. I know, right?
if color is a digit, and we'll just say print input is not a string. I realize I'm doing this backwards, but because it gave me the digit first, I'm thinking that way, right? Else, I'm gonna do print your color. Hold on, we'll do color equals string. This is our color. Color that you put in is again, Jesus. That there, and I don't know, something dumb, something easy like that. Again, you caught me off guard. Oops, invalid syntax because I.
You're doing just fine, JJ.
Yeah. You asked me to spin up a Kubernetes cluster. Everything's fine. But you asked me to write some simple Python with like 20 people watching. And I'm like, I don't know what I'm doing.
Just makes it more fun, man.
Oh, yeah. No, good point. Good point. So we'll say four. Then who's going to win? I should have dropped into that.
What the yellow.
Yo, hey, good call. Good call. Oh, it didn't actually do it. Why didn't it do it? Probably because where I put it. So we'll go ahead and.
You get some compliments on your Python skills here.
No, I didn't. I didn't do that. Did they really?
Yep.
Hey, thanks for that. That's actually that. Thank you for that. That's very
and,
sweet.
And people are asking for the repo for the turtle game.
No, they're not. Are they really?
No. Yeah.
Oh wow. No, I haven't actually put it. Like I said, it was me and my daughter doing this stuff. So, but I could totally put this up if people don't care. All right, one more time, just to see if I can do it. Here we go. Here it's a color of a turtle. What color are we gonna do? We're gonna do blue, because I just want to see this actually catch it. And the color of our turtle was blue. That's what we wanted to see. So we actually did actually working code to make that happen. And then we're gonna do three more turtles racing. Who's gonna win? Yeah, who's gonna win? Orange, pink, purple. Oh, purple. Purple
pink,
all the
pink,
way.
Pink.
Ah, purple. Ah, there we go. Good stuff. Good stuff. Well,
I'm so bad at gambling, man.
That's probably a good thing.
Yeah, probably.
cool. Well, I'm feeling great across the board here. I saw Tabnine working how I needed it to. It really did take the cognitive overhead, and that was just literally installing it 10 minutes earlier. It already looked through some stuff, already figured out some things that we needed to, and it just
it really does only get better and more accurate and even quicker the more you use it. And yeah. That's a good practice to add any assistance that you can have to make sure that your code is being written correctly. And to make things more efficient in terms of time resources, and in terms of, you know, not going away from your code editor after every second line to search online for how people did it before. Just take the suggestions in. Most of the time they will be exactly what you need there. It makes you feel more. For me, I can say that when I started using Tabnine, even before being part of the team, it made me feel more confident about my coding skills, because I have my special assistant that is sitting on my machine all the time. I don't need to ask small questions about things that are actually pretty easy to solve, yeah. And that just make things. Just make things more calm when you work. This is how I feel. This is how I take it.
That's so good. No, you said it beautifully, and I feel that. I truly do, and that's amazing. Well, I mean, yeah. I don't have anywhere better to finish other than that. That's like, that was truly heartfelt. And I can see that that's coming from there.
Now we need the fin slide, you know, yeah. to the end of the film noir film that we have here. We'll always have tab 9.
Yep.
Fading out.
I love it. That's so good. Awesome. Well, I'll give it 10 more seconds or so, just to see if anyone wants to throw any last questions in. Otherwise, I'm going to go ahead and end the stream because I saw everything I need to see.
I see Battle Dash is saying that at this point, GPT-4, which is just an imaginary model that's that doesn't exist yet, saying that it will write its own code. Oh, the GPT-4 will write its own code, meaning that the model will actually write itself. That could be true. I hope it won't, but it might happen. But AI is our friend. Don't be afraid of it. It's here to help us. We control it. It's not going to take our jobs. It's not going to take over the world. Stay calm. The world needs developers, and it will need developers for a long time. Don't give up on your dreams. Keep on coding.
That's beautiful. All right, Yot. Say bye, Yot.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for being here, and thank you, JJ. It was such a pleasure.
Okay.